takes or anything. So with something like this, you know what I mean? You look at it and you see like that little piece got magnetized in like how little time, and it's already like on the board ready to go. And now here's my next one right there. And you know, my brother made a good point with that. He's like, you know, sometimes people do want to see like the actual process, because the process itself is, you know, what shows you what actually went into it, versus like, you know, Instagram, when you just see like, you know, the final product or whatever, you see like the picture, you don't see the countless hours and backstage amount of work and everything that goes into something. And honestly, makes a lot of sense. It really is true. And I mean, I might not show you every like 2 seconds what I'm doing, but I'm basically just doing the same thing over and over again. I'm just lining up, making sure the polarity is the direction that I want it in as best I can, because, you know, obviously everyone makes mistakes. You'll definitely have some where you do them wrong. And it's never the end of the world. I've had it before where I had to like carve back out bits and then go back in with green stuff. And although it seems catastrophic at the time, it's really not that big of a deal. So, and then that guy right here, we got another split on, so I can do whatever I want with that one. I think what I want to do is set it up so I could do like another vent, maybe like type deal out of the top right there. So again, all we're gonna do is just line it up with the tip of that little fan in there. The very like little, it's like a little bolt that goes through the center, like the little axis the fan spins on. And we're just gonna put our drill bit right on that axis. And if you like have a terrible time doing it, or it jumps on you a couple times or whatever, and it's just not working, or it's not starting where you want it to, all you can do is just take your razor blade and just kind of scrape out the center and, you know, get it started that way. And then you can, you know, basically get it to do whatever you want. I mean, it's all just plastic anyway, so no matter how much it fights you, it can only do so much. Like, it's a little piece of plastic, and you are, you know, a man or a woman. Probably a man, statistically, if you're watching this. But, yeah, so there we got. We just pop one right in there. And then now we can put, like, we can either split it off, like, this way or whatever, or we can put, you know, one of our random little accessories or whatever on that. And it just gives, like, a tiny bit more of, like, you know, the three-dimensional, like, sort of look to the board. Which is, you know, it's really what we're going for. We're basically just trying to make this all look like cool and crazy and exciting. You know what I mean? That is, I think, one that I wanted to have going in the other direction, though. But yeah, like I said, the key is that when it's all said and done, you need to have like some accessories that are like, well, I mean, you don't need to, but what I'm going to do is have some accessories that are like painted in the other direction, or other color rather. So all it's going to do is basically just like at a glance, when you see like something that's bright blue or whatever on one of these connections, you know, like that's where the polarity reverses. So, you know, if you want to change out like a joint or a connection or whatever, it's not a problem to figure out exactly where you need to make that change at or whatever. You know, and again, it's just little tricks of the trade and stuff like that. Is the only reason I say that is because I've had to do different things like that. So, but yeah, now we're gonna do one of these little bad boys right here. And actually, I'm not sure which one I need, so I'm gonna use this one. This is another important piece. If you look at this guy right here, they're actually the same height. So if you put them next to each other, like the pipe ends up in the same place when they're done. But if you spin them the other way, this one doesn't have a difference. It's the same no matter which way you spin it. This one changes like the final trajectory of the pipe off of like a flat surface. It's higher up there, and then you can switch it, spin around, and then it's lower, like flush on the surface there. So this one actually gives you a lot more options. The other one, you know, is necessary in some situations, though, especially as you start doing what I'm doing, you're getting into like the actual 3D building. Like, this one is required if you want the pipe to run like around a, like flush with the ground, or like the side of the building or something like that, or if you need it to be like, that exact distance, you know, basically of the pillars themselves or whatever, versus, you know, this one gives you no options, because no matter which way you spin it, it's going to be the same. This one gives you basically the option to change. So now if we take this, I can't even imagine when this board is like fully done, how hard it's going to be to like try to move anything or touch anything. I need to put obviously a second piece over here so it has something to stick to, because it's just falling off every time I try to do it. But yeah, I just need, I'm just going to do our same deal with this. Just going to put a little bit of glue right in there. And you could actually use, they have like a larger size that's still the same diameter and everything than the ones I put in the video title and everything. I like these ones specifically because they're like the same width as the plastic that Games Workshop uses, so they're like extremely useful just in general, because having that line up, like you can drill out a little hole and then put the magnet in and it sits flush. But they have ones that are thicker as well. That, you know, essentially you could, if you have one that's twice as thick, it'll be like twice as strong. Or you can just like double these up, like when you see fit, you know, which is typically what I do, just cause it works out more convenient that way, having the option. And you know, these come in like huge packs of like hundreds, so it's not that big of a deal. So as you can see now, we basically have our length set up how we want, right there. All we need to modify is where our final destination of this pipe sits in. So now what we want to do is look and see which size piece we need to fill that gap, and as you'll see, it's basically going to be, we can use one of these. It's going to be hard to keep that where it wants to be. And, but yeah. So you can see we need, it's not quite long enough right here how it needs to be to connect those pieces. So we can just sort of use one or two of these guys to see how far off we are. So that looks pretty good right there. All right, and then let's see how that goes. So yeah, that looks basically like where we're gonna end up. This connection looks just like a little janky, because this isn't sitting up on supports, but this is the height of supports. But as you can see, what we need for the final piece is, it's one of the ones where we do the cut in half, but only one of these pieces. So the one I have up there right now is just a little longer. Now, honestly, it's not that big of a deal in this specific situation, just because the part where it comes down to the ground doesn't have to be the exact length of this setup right here, because this thing is just going to end a little bit further from the wall than it would have if I would have just left it how it was. But, you know, there's no reason to be picky in this situation, but if you needed to, you could, and that's why we have all these different options is, you know, so you can basically change up how this all interacts. But the basic goal was today, before the video, to essentially link up our pipe back here with our pipe over here. And you know, that's obviously what we did. Definitely looks pretty cool, and very happy with it. And we have tons of little like end caps and stuff that we can like add on wherever we want. And then we have different supports and stuff like that as well. So definitely did well with that one. I did want to talk about specifically now the little supports for the pipes here as well. Basically, all they are is like just these little legs. And when you take a piece of the piping, for instance, this piece right here, you put the legs underneath, and it allows that piping to sit flush on something, just a little bit off of the ground. Just like I was saying back here, it sits up just a little bit. Well, when you go to use these, you may have a situation where you have basically like a piece running up the side of a pillar or something like that, and you want the pipe to be stuck onto that. So what I did was, and let me just grab one of these random ones out of here. I'm trying to think which one I could grab without messing with the whole thing. But say you were like wanting this pipe to basically just run up the side of that right there. You'll see, just gonna spin that around there. You'll see now we have this one on the top location. So when this is sitting flush on the ground, this little rim right here lines up with that top location. So what we can do is we can take one of our little legs for the pipe that we were just showing there, and we can actually take this little guy off of there. And that wasn't magic. I had two of them in my hand, in case you're wondering how I dropped that and then still put it on. And then basically, you can just get that where it needs to be, and then the pipe will line up perfectly and sit in there. So now you have two options. You can either glue this leg onto the pipe right here, and then the way I decided it is, if you had like a two piece, you would put it on the center one. If you had a three piece, you would put it on the center one as well. But it's basically just how you would space it out so that you could have it on like the side of the pillar running up as well with the mounts. But now if you wanted to and you didn't want to glue it or whatever, you could just pick your facing how you want this to be, and then essentially just line this piece up and then drill a hole in that piece, and that's where it would sit. This piece would basically be magnetized to that, so you could have this magnetized to that, and then you could have the whole thing magnetized onto the side of the building. So, and all you would have to do for that is just pick where you want your magnet to be, which one of these rings, and then just drill a hole in there and just stick another magnet. And now all of a sudden you have the ability to use these accessories on the side of the building to hold them in place as well. So, and matter of fact, you know what? I mean, we're here now. I might as well just show you guys on one of these pieces how to do it. I did want to make this into a double. So what I want to do is, boy, now that it's all put together, I can't tell where one ends and the next one starts. That's awesome. I mean, that's kind of the goal, I think, right? Indistinguishable. Is that it? No. That one's... I'm looking for the one that we made the exact height. This guy right here. So if we took this one basically and did it on the central pillar, it would line up perfectly. So what we're gonna do is, just gonna grab this guy and just gonna line it up with this essentially. Which part I would want to be facing out, because you assume whichever part's facing the wall is going to be less visible. So we'll just pick the area with like the least amount of detail. So like the coolest part, maybe that little vent right there is facing out, and it doesn't matter which way is up or down with this either. So now we're just going to follow that line right there, and we're just going to put a hole right in the middle along that line and along the seam where we glued these two together. because this was the one where we cut the middle out.